If you have a motorized beach cruiser, you've probably asked the question, how the heck do I work on these coaster brakes? I've had a lot of people asking me about these lately. So, as you can see, I have a little bit of a gap in between the actual coaster brake arm and the wall. How I did that was I got rid of the dust cover that was under there. This part right here. This is the dust cover. When you take the coaster brake arm off, this will actually be under it. Mine actually has a star pattern. I love this pattern. But a lot of y'all's will just kind of be like a oval shape with two flat sides. You'll have a dust cover. I would recommend getting rid of this, but do not use the dust cover, because when you put the sprocket on, it's going to actually rub against these walls and it's going to be very hard to pedal, and you're just going to end up burning your hub up. Save you the trouble, throw out the dust cover. And now I will change camera angles real quick and show you how to disassemble, clean, and reassemble your coaster brake without leaving too much wobble in the axle or having it too tight. You might want to save this video, because you will need this video again. It helps to hold the arm in place because it stops everything from turning. And just loosen this. If you're taking your wheel apart for the first time, this nut will be on very tight. And remove it completely. These are very fine threads, so don't lose this. Set it aside where you're going to find it later. You have one washer, and there's my coaster brake arm. I cut a notch in it because my frame, the tubing actually wouldn't clear, but it's still plenty strong enough to stop. Once again, my wheels have a star pattern. I bought a Whizzer wheels off the old Motorized bicycles. If you type that into eBay, the 105 high density steel wheels come up. That's what I recommend you use. I don't recommend you use aluminum wheels with a motorized bicycle kit, because it'll just eat the spokes to pieces, man. Now, when you get in there, there's your hub for the coaster brake lever. That's what it sits on. Mine's a star pattern. Freaking awesome. You have two sides of this wheel. You have this part. Your entire axle is threaded. And you have this half. This half's usually super tightened. Don't even bother taking this side apart. What you want to do is hold the actual hub of the lever. What the lever plugs into. It's how you stop. You want to hang on to it with one hand and just back this out. This will take the entire guts out of it. Just hang on to it and hold it in there. This is how you put it back together, too. Hold the parts inside there. Do not let them come out. Let the axle come out of this side. Okay. When you have it, this will actually unscrew. It has very steep threads. And you can actually pull this out. And all your bearings, the wheels, will face in to the cup. So they would just sit in there like that. You never want to put collar into the cup, because it'll just tear it up. So I'll just go ahead and drop it back down into that hub like that. I'll just tip this down. My thumb is still in place holding everything down. This side, usually you don't really do much with. What you're going to want to do, though, is all the old grease in here, see how black that is? Wipe all of the grease off everything and go to your hardware store or auto parts store and just get some Lucas Oil Products grease. The red grease is awesome. And regrease everything. be sure to have lots of paper towels handy, because you're going to need them. You can also use shop towels or just a regular old rag that you have lying around. Now here's the huge mystery of the coaster brake. You have this part, which I will go ahead and clean the grease off of these so you can see it. It's kind of hard to make out a freaking blob. So, alright. You have this part, that's what the coaster brake lever goes on. It's all threaded inside, make sure the threads are still good. Now you'll have two flat sides like this. And I'll show you what that's for in just a moment, but you'll also have these two slots in here kind of cut out. It's not round anymore. That's actually for this next part. I will go ahead and dump out the remainder of the parts into my hand here. Now you have two pads. Just like this. I'll go ahead and wipe all the grease off. It makes it very difficult to see with huge blobs of grease. This is what your pads should look like with grooves in them. Then you have a big side like this. It goes down to a skinny side like that. This is my favorite part. The hole in the sprocket is the perfect size to put new guts in, or to clean and put them back in. That is so handy, you have no idea. Because these 9 bolts are such a pain in the butt to take out of these rings in the back and put them back in. I use an electric ratchet and it still takes forever. Alright, this is what's in the middle of your wheel. It actually just drops in like that. You got these two tabs and there's actually a spring in here. Make sure this is as level as possible. If you want to push it down or stretch it, don't pull it all the way out, just make sure it's nice and flat. It actually fits in to the first part I showed you, just like that. Two little tabs go in there, and that's actually how you brake. It'll spring and bring everything close. Now your brake pads, the big part, remember this is the outside, it just fits right there. Just fits right into that groove. It won't move from there when it's inside the wheel. That's all there is to it. That's the entire core of your wheel. All you need now is your bearing with the wheels down. And you'll want to regrease everything. Put it all back together. Make sure these two are in the grooves. And I can hold this together with one hand. It's not a huge deal. And you'll want to, once you heavily regrease everything, lots of grease, alright? Put everything pre-assembled into the wheel. Your coaster brake lever you took off went on this little adapter. This is the first part you will start with. And your tube of grease. When you're greasing it, it will actually help hold it together like glue. So, actually, take some grease, wipe it all over this. Actually, separate this. Never forget to put your bearing on first. Ball bearings down, the rollers down on the collar. Okay. Lots of grease. It helps to keep a big handful of grease during this, just like this. Just smear some as you go. Just smear and assemble. Take the brake pad. Sorry, the camera keeps going out of focus. It's been acting up lately. Since this will be on a motorized bicycle, I recommend using a lot of grease. Okay. Now it's basically just all held together in a big greasy. Looks kind of like a D-cell battery, but that's your whole hub. What you're going to want to do is take the rest of your grease that's on your hand right now and run it inside the actual hub itself. Then it doesn't hurt to keep a lot of paper towels around for this step. Stand your wheel up. Carefully take your assembled hub mechanism. Pop it back into the wheel. Make sure your bearing sits flat. During this step, I'll sit the wheel back down. And you don't have to take any of this off this part. You can just slide it all apart just like this. Stuff grease down in there. Grease the heck out of this bearing. Doesn't hurt to do this every month or so if you do a lot of riding. There's a lot of grease in the wheel. It's really gonna run around in there. I don't want to put too much. While holding that in, just screw it through the hub. I will speed up the footage because these are very fine threads and this takes a little bit. Alright, when you get down to this part, you're going to want to take this, and it's got those big threads on that, just run it down into the hub. Don't tighten it or anything, just to where it just wants to stop. Take some of this extra grease and throw it back in that bearing. I didn't get it very well a minute ago. All this extra grease is going to run out of here in a second. That's why it's a good idea to have towels handy. Now this will move. That's actually what stops and everything. It actuates everything inside. It's all threaded through the front of the wheel. Now what you're going to want to do is, without your dust cover, put it all back together. The star kind of has a tight fit. Your washer. And the nut. Alright, this step may sometimes require three hands because this is actually turning the whole axle and the guts on the inside. It'll actually turn this whole side and this, so pretty much just back it off to where this is still loose and then hold this side. Make sure it's still just to where it stops. You may have to put a wrench on this, have someone hold it while you put a wrench back on the lever and tighten the nut back down. Now, if this is hard to spin, you need to loosen this a little more because this side spun on you. This could be a pain in the butt. So just put a wrench right there, make sure this doesn't turn, hold it here and tighten this down, and then it'll work. There's no side-to-side movement, free spins. That is how you rebuild and adjust your coaster brake and bend the lever out of the way to work with the motor kit. If you have any questions, just leave them in the comment box below. Thanks for watching.